Cast off bell knife.
Aye, aye, sir. Bow and away.
Engine room. On board. Down last bell. Statesman, sound off. Give me a depth reading by the mark. There she goes. Captain, welcome aboard the Liberty. I'm your captain, Horace Bixby, and my pilot with me here on the Texas deck is a yellow cub that goes by the name of Sam Clemens. And he's marking his 100 points down the river today when he drank the Liberty on his voyage. Sam knows this good boy all right now. Sam, tell our guest everything you know about this river.
Well, now, I always figure it is better to keep your mouth shut and get stupid when you're open and remove all the doubt. But I will tell you this, I love this river more than anything else. I've loved this river even from the time I was a toddler back in Missouri. Before we get too much further out of port, I think I should mention that you best not be sitting on those handrails. They're the only thing between you and the river. And the river don't always take kindly to uninvited guests. We've also had reports of river pilots operating in the vicinity. So I wouldn't lean out beyond those rails for that reason either. Now, for those of you on the port side, that river town we're passing is frontier land.
If you know where to look. And we all knew where to look.
That's superstition bridge. It connects the big island to the little one. And if you follow the wilderness trail there, it'll lead you right up to the gates of Fort Langhorne. It's the last trading outpost before we head into Indian country. Look along the port side there. Every now and then, the water under that crested rock comes to a natural boil and spurts out all over the place like a tea kettle left on the fire too long. Indians around here used to tell me these geysers were actually unfriendly spirits, upset by uninvited trespassers traipsing all over their sacred hunting ground. Be that as it may, that's Big Thunder Mountain poking up in the sky over there. The Indians named it that because of the sound the falls used to make when the big rains came. The miners and prospectors and get-rich-quick speculators showed up, and the name stuck because of the sound of blasting powder going off every few minutes. There's not so much blasting these days. Ghost story. A runaway mine train loaded down with simple-hearted, terror-filled folks like you.
Fire food. And I thought it was a sport.
Ahmed Abusa. Just beyond the village, up that hill, is their sacred burial ground. And those who fall in battle are placed atop the traditional bed of death. After nightfall, they'll return to warm the great warriors and pour honor to the drum.
Back over yonder there in the woods, I've heard folks
you're about to say it's haunted. They say it was built on sacred Indian burial grounds, so now it's filled with spirits. But if you ask me, I'd say the ones telling those tales are the ones filled with spirits. If you want proof, just ask them. They got it. About 100 proof, I reckon. And whatever you do, don't strike any matches if they aim to breathe in your direction. And you won't just be seeing ghosts, you'll be joining them.
Thank you, everyone, for traveling the rivers of America with us today.